Okay, and Tatum has her two shapes. Tatum, show them the two circles that you chose. Okay, and we're gonna use these shapes to trace circles. We're gonna use that circle activity that we did last week, but today we're gonna make it into a painting. So Tatum is gonna trace part of the circle into one of the corners. And you don't have to do it in the corner, you can do it on the side. After Tatum finishes, I'll show you a couple of examples. And then she's gonna overlap her second circle. And the idea is we're gonna do these circles a few times across the page, and we're gonna practice that paint mixing overlap technique that we worked on last week. Awesome, Tatum. So Tatum's finished. She chose to do three of the large circles and four of the small. And you can place the large circles off the page, on the page, however you want. The main thing is that you capture a couple sets of that overlap because we're gonna work on our mixing technique. So the first thing that we're gonna do, and Tatum has chosen yellow, is we're gonna take the paint that's called wash, and we're gonna paint the whole piece of paper all over with that color. So whatever your color for wash is, you're gonna use that as the base and cover your whole piece of paper.
Except for under the circles too,
all through, you'll see. It's really interesting. At first I was really afraid to try it because I'm like, is it gonna hide all
but
the pencil marks?
It in here.
All over the, cover the whole piece of paper. And you'll see that the lines still show up really nicely. And the thing I like about the brushes that we're using for the wash part is it leaves a nice little brush texture in there to give the painting some depth. A wash is basically a word for describing when you use like a thinner paint to go over the whole canvas or whatever you're working on. And you're just using that as your base color. A lot of artists use different base colors and then they build off that base color for the rest of their painting. The thing I like about the paint we're using is that it's pretty transparent, so you're still gonna be able to see the circles really well when you go to paint within them. And if you do it while the wash is still wet, you're gonna pick up a little bit of the yellow, which is fun too. I like to call what we're doing here the bubble painting because I feel like with the wash, it feels like you're underwater, even though the color that you're using might not be blue or a typical watercolor. You're going to have this effect of these different layers of color, translucent, coming through, which I really like. All right, Tatum, that looks awesome. So Tatum's completed her wash. Now she can set that brush aside and begin to use one of the smaller brushes that she selected. And for her two kind of bubble colors, we'll call them, she's chosen a teal and then a darker blue. And what she's gonna do is for each set of circles, she's gonna choose which color will be the big circle and which color will be the little, and then be sure to do a mix of the two for the smaller pieces. So I recommend starting with one of the solid pieces first and doing the mixing after. So Tatum, which paint are you gonna start with and which shape? And you'll notice that the blue is gonna pick up a little bit of the yellow because she's doing it while it's still wet, and I love that effect. It's gonna bring in some really interesting colors and also some shading, which will give the shapes a little bit of unintended depth. So we're just checking in on Tatum's painting, and she's finished kind of her darker use of the dark blue, and now she's moving into the teal. And you'll notice some of her earlier circles really picked up the yellow underneath in a really beautiful way. And now the yellow is kind of dried, so we're gonna see more of the solid color, and she's just beginning the other portion of her shapes. And what she did was she chose that any two circles overlapping would be different colors, and that's how she plotted kind of what color she would use where. So we'll check in with her in a minute. Tatum has just finished her solid colors and she's gonna begin mixing. And the cool thing about this project is you're only mixing the same two colors together. So you can make a big batch of it. So she's putting the teal on her little piece of paper here. And I forgot to mention at the beginning, but you definitely want some sort of messy paper or something that you can get dirty underneath you, because you're going to the full edge with your painting. So whether it's newspaper, if anybody has those anymore, I think that's good, Tate. That's a lot of paint, so you probably don't need too much more. No, all good. We're just learning about amounts and all that stuff. So you'll need as much blue. Okay, so Tatum has completed the solid colors, and now she's mixed a little bit of the teal and the dark blue on the paper, and she's beginning to fill in those middle pieces, and you'll see that it's a really beautiful color of the teal mixed with the dark blue. Oh, I love that. Such a pretty color. And she's going to use that in all of the middle places that she has. And the effect when you step away from it is like bubbles.
Jamie's calling now.
Mm-hmm. While Tatum's finishing up that, I'll show you my two examples. So I did one with dark hues, and I used kind of a blue-gray wash in the background, and a dark purple with some yellow. So that's kind of one way that I tried it. And then I tried like a very bright and cheery color version, and that is this one. The paper curled a little bit, so it's kind of hard. I need to put it in between some books to stay flat.
Okay, I'm done.
But look at that. Oh, Tatum's done. Yay! And there's the completed painting, which is just going to be take a few minutes to dry, and then it'll be ready for hanging. Hope you enjoyed the project, guys.